As we go to air tonight, the man accused of stalking TV star Sophie Monk is behind bars. In a frightening development, Brian Rapley's been caught on camera inside the office of Sophie's management. That vision was handed to police and they pounced.
From serious to scary, Brian Rapley leaving court in the custody of New South Wales Corrective Services. He allegedly breached an apprehended violence order protecting Nine star Sophie Monk when he visited her manager's office yesterday.
Hey Brian, what's with the relationship with Sophie, mate?
Leave me alone, mate.
Remember, this is the same bloke who claimed to be a love-struck victim of catfishing by a Sophie impersonator. In May, a current affair obtained alarming security video of an unsolicited visit by Rapley to Monk's home holding a rose on Anzac Day. He returned later that night, prowled around the front and back of her property and tried her doors and windows. Monk wasn't there at the time, but says this vision terrified her.
Get away from
Hey,
me.
Easy, buddy, easy.
No. Hey, hey, buddy, you come to me house, hey, mate.
Last month, the magistrate sent Rapley a clear message. He ordered the unemployed man to not approach Monk or contact her in any way, unless through a lawyer, and not go within 500 metres of her home and workplace. But yesterday afternoon, Rapley is alleged to have breached that order. Police say CCTV shows Rapley turning up to the office of Monk's management, 22, in Sydney, Surry Hills. He appears to speak into the intercom and is buzzed into the building. Rapley enters the foyer, then climbs the stairs to the elevator where the security vision ends.
Monk's manager, Patrick Green, says Rapley knocked on his office door. He says when he answered it, Rapley asked to see Sophie. Green says he recognised Rapley straight away and immediately called police.
Officers swooped on Rapley at his ramshackle home in Western Sydney just after 7 this morning. They charged him with breaching an AVO and took him to Penrith Police Station. Rapley was questioned and refused police bail, ensuring he had to face a court magistrate. The prosecution told the court its case is strong and Rapley posed an unacceptable risk to the victim if he was released. Rapley told police Sophie Monk contacted him on Instagram, claiming she was using the name Sophie Mueller, and invited him to her management office to pick her up because she wanted to go to his house. Penrith Court Magistrate George Breton responded by saying Rapley was
well aware the person he was asking for was Sophie Monk, knowing the management company is connected to the person in protection.
This wasn't the first time Rapley had visited the office. Monk claims he did the same when he couldn't find her on Anzac Day.
When a current affair first showed Rapley prowling around Monk's house, some people believed his story that he was set up by an online Monk impersonator. Now, after this latest development, those same people may well question whether they still buy Rapley's version of events.
If Rapley was feeling lonely before this, then imagine what he's feeling tonight.
Brian Rapley now has a week to reflect on things. He's due back in court next Thursday.